Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk more about space maintainers in kids. And this is really actually more of a pediatric dentistry video. I don't place this type of space maintainer. Not interested. Don't do it. It's something that's placed by a dentist, or usually most commonly a pediatric dentist, when a tooth is pulled out. So in this situation, I don't know if this actually makes sense to me, but in this situation, it would have been a first molar that was pulled out, okay? First molar are your sixes. Those are the teeth that normally come in when you're 6 years old, six, seven, something like that. First permanent molar came out. They put a band and loop space maintainer in to maintain the space so that this tooth wouldn't tip forward. This patient, since there was a second molar, this patient would have to be at least 12. This doesn't totally make sense to me, but I mean, it's good they did it. So most commonly, I would say band and loops are placed on baby teeth, okay? Or on permanent teeth because there was an early extraction of a baby tooth, okay? And my opinion might be different than what is taught in pediatric dentistry. I tend to see an overuse of space maintainers when I think it's really not necessary. So first thing you're gonna do, if you're pulling a baby tooth out for whatever reason, whether it was decayed, unrestorable, you know, traumatized, it had to go before it's time, is you're gonna take an x-ray, right? If that permanent tooth that's underneath it is like pretty much gonna erupt the next month or so, you don't need to place a space maintainer, or even the next 2 months. You know, if it's right there, don't place a space maintainer. I see this all the time, and it's more trouble than it's worth, because then that it's either blocking the eruption of the permanent teeth, which can cause permanent damage or impactions, unless the patient is coming in regularly to get it checked. Or a lot of times these things can go into the gums and cause major issues. I've seen some crazy stuff happen with these suckers when they're not monitored. You know, patients eat whatever. They're eating candy and all kind of other stuff, and it can cause damage. So, you know, don't place one if you don't need it. I generally, and granted, the kids that I'm seeing in our offices, you know, historically have been older, you know, six and up. The only time I think you need a space maintainer is when either a permanent tooth is missing, you know, and they're not ready for orthodontic treatment, because if it's orthodontic treatment, we might be able to use up the space or move it around, or we'll do something, you know, take care of that issue. Or if a second baby molar, not first baby molar, not baby canine, second baby molar, which is in the US, it's your A, your J, your K, and your T, got extracted early. That means normally the other word for that is E's. We call those E's in ortho. They call them, goodness, what is it in international term? It's 5, 5, 6, 5, 7, 5, and 8, 5. So those, any of those, the ones that come up when you're 2 years old, 2 year old baby molars, second baby molars. If those come up and if those come up and the 5, which is your second premolar, which is your 4, your 13, your 20, and your 29, if those aren't just about to come up, you do absolutely need a space maintainer placed same time, within a week, 100%. That drives me absolutely nuts when I see a patient that wouldn't have needed braces and wouldn't have needed a complicated treatment at all, maybe didn't need it at all, and now you just cost this family $7,000 because you were sloppy and didn't put in a space maintainer. That makes me really, 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 really mad, and I see it all the time. I don't understand. Why are doctors pulling these teeth out without immediately placing a space maintainer? If the patient, I mean, you should just do it all at one time. Don't, if the patient's parents say no, then I wouldn't be pulling out the tooth. So, because you're condemning this patient to really difficult ortho later, most of the time. It makes it so much harder, you know, and sometimes a really bad outcome because you were sloppy and didn't place a space maintainer. And more commonly than not, I see space maintainers overly used when they don't need to be used. Like 90% of the time, I'm like, you didn't need this. You know, I feel like sometimes it's either Medicaid fraud or just an overly cautious dentist that didn't realize they did not need a space maintainer there. It probably wasn't malicious. Sometimes it probably is. But it's like, really? Take these all off. You know, get rid of them. But yeah, so band and loops, I don't put them on, but I see them all the time. I take them off all the time. Definitely. Goodbye. You don't need this. Let's get rid of it. And I only use them for missing permanent teeth or for missing second baby molars, the E's. Your A, your J, your K, your T, or your 8.5, your 7.5, your 6.5, and your 5.5. That's the times when you need to use them, okay? Otherwise, usually don't need them. Maybe, I don't know, maybe in like 2-3 year olds, maybe you do, I don't know. That's a pediatric dental question. I've never seen an issue, let's put it that way, in all my 20 years of being an orthodontist, I have never ever seen damage that's been caused by a patient long-term or a mess up an ortho plan because one wasn't placed. It was pulled early. That's actually not true. If you take out a baby canine, just one, sometimes the midlines will shift, but it's not a huge damage. It's like so easy to fix. You know, maybe you'll get a slightly impacted canine, but that's easy to fix. That's not bad. It's when these suckers drift forward. Well, not this, but if this was missing and this drifted forward, that's an issue. So, all right. Hopefully that was helpful. And you know, if there's two, I would much prefer a lingual arch than two bands and loops. It's much more comfortable for the patient and it has a lot of great orthodontic benefits. So I love me a lingual arch. So, or an ants, those are great too. TPA, those are great too. We use them all the time. So, and it's an incredible thing to put in either a patient with a little overjet or a patient with a slight underbite to put those in for preventative. I have a lot of emails. I have a lot of videos on YouTube about space maintainers used for anchorage control. So you definitely should check those out. All right, thanks so much.